Morning to our Sunday school lesson. It is great to be back with you for another one. And with me are, as always, my two very special helpers, Miss Hannah.
Hi.
And Mr. Marcus.
Hi.
And this morning we are going to bring you a Bible lesson that kind of works off of last week. Do you remember what we did last week? We talked about Jesus not dying, but rising from the dead, right? And so we're going to continue to talk about the resurrection. And before we do that, I have a question for you guys. Do you like to go on walks?
Yeah.
Yeah?
When it's not a rainy day.
When it's not a rainy day. Maybe you guys like to go on walks. Maybe you like to play out on the playground or even walk to the playground.
Or you can ride on your bike. That's funner.
That is fun. Yes. Well, many, many years ago, before there was airplanes, before there were cars or trikes or bikes or any of that stuff, people had to walk from place to place. And on that first Sunday, that day in which Jesus rose from the dead, two friends were walking along to a city called Emmaus. Can you say Emmaus?
Emmaus.
Emmaus, yes. And these friends were very, very sad. They were talking about Jesus, and they were sad that he had died on Good Friday. And they didn't understand why Jesus had to suffer and die. In fact, one of the men said, hey, some of the women, some of our friends who are women, they said that Jesus is alive. Can that really be true? Well, soon someone was coming at them as they're walking down the road. And who do you think it was?
Jesus.
It was Jesus. Jesus was walking at them. And he was listening to what they were saying. Jesus was. He was listening in on their conversation. And Jesus asks them, hey, what are you guys talking about? Now, they didn't recognize Jesus. They didn't know it was him. And Jesus says, what are you guys talking about? And they look at him kind of like, are you kidding me? Haven't you been around for the last couple days? Haven't you heard about this man, Jesus, that they have killed on a cross? And they go on to tell how Jesus was so kind to people, how he would heal the sick, how he would help those around him. And they said, hey, Jesus died, and he told us that he was going to rise 3 days later. But that can't really be true, is it? Could a man really die and rise from the dead? Well, Jesus says to these two men, he says, you shouldn't be so sad. God's word tells something different. And what does the Bible tell us? What does the Bible tell us about Jesus? That he was going to rise from the dead, right? We know that Jesus, yes, had to die on the cross to save us from our sins, but he also promised to rise from the dead, and he did just that. And he goes on to tell these two men that truth, that promise, and he tells them many other things in the Bible. And soon, they get to the house where they were going to stay for the night, and they're hanging out with Jesus, and they're having dinner. And Jesus takes some bread and he breaks it and he thanks God and he gives it to the men. And guess what? They recognize Jesus. All of a sudden they realize that this was Jesus. And they realize that he was alive. He had risen just as he said. And they were happy. They were happy. They were excited. And so they go and they tell people about Jesus being alive. They say, we've seen Jesus. You're not going to believe it. He really is alive, just as he said. Tell the good news. So first they had to see, and then they were able to tell. Now, you and me, we don't get to see Jesus with our eyes, right? But we still hear his word, right, Marcus? We still know what the Bible tells us. We still know that the Bible tells us that we are loved and that we are forgiven. And God wants us to be just like those other followers on that resurrection day. He wants us to go out and tell people about who he is and what he has done. So that's what you guys are to do, and you guys are to do. Okay, so to help us remember that, about sharing and telling and seeing and hearing, we are going to do a craft that is hopefully really, really simple. And so what you're going to need is you are going to need at least 2 toilet paper rolls per child. And then you're going to need some stickers to decorate with, some markers. You're going to need a little bit of yarn. And then anything else that you want to decorate these with. Now, we have wrapped ours in construction paper and we have taped it on there. If you want to do that, you can do that. Or the other thing that you could do is paint or color directly onto it. But we wanted to make it a little bit nicer surface for the kids to draw on and color on. So we did that, but you don't have to. Next, what you are going to do is you are going to take your toilet paper rolls and you are going to either staple them together or tape them together. Okay? So what we're going to do is we are going to tape ours together. And I'll show you how we're going to do this. We are going to tape it together. And what it's going to look like when you get it all done. It's going to look like that. Okay? So, once you get to this point, then you can start decorating. Start putting stickers on there, coloring, put all kinds of stuff on there. You can wrap pipe cleaners around there, anything that you want to decorate it. So go ahead and do that, and then come back, and we will show you exactly what it is that you have made, okay? Okay, we are back, and Marcus and Hannah have decorated their toilet paper rolls, and they look beautiful. What you're going to do after that is you're going to make 2 holes. You're going to need Mom and Dad's help for this. You're going to make 2 holes. Take your yarn and attach them just with little knots through your holes. And what we have made, what do you think this is?
Binoculars!
Yes, we have made binoculars. Look at, so you can put it over your head. And what do you use binoculars for?
Hunting!
We use them for hunting, but it's so that you can do what?
See
far.
Right.
It's so, you use it the wrong way.
Yeah, it's so that you can see things, okay? And Jesus gives us, you and me and all of you guys, eyes of faith. And those eyes of faith, we see through his word, and we believe. Hello? We believe, and we believe in who? Who do we believe in? We believe in Jesus. Right, right. Remember, when those 2 men, when they saw Jesus, and they finally realized that it was him, what did they go do?
They told other people.
So we can see Jesus in his word. We see the things that he does and the things that he promises us. And then we can go tell people about it. So I want you guys to go tell people. Go tell grandma and grandpa, and go tell your friends and your family. Go tell your aunts and your uncles and your brothers and your sisters. Go tell everybody about Jesus, that he has died on the cross, that he has rose from the dead because he loves you and because he forgives you. Okay? Let's pray. Let's hold our hands, Mark. We're going to pray. Dear Jesus, help us to hear your word and to see that all of the things that you promise us have come true. Help us to know the truth that you have risen from the dead, and help us to go and tell the wonderful news about Jesus to everyone. In your name we pray, amen. All right, guys, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Let's say bye.